That's good, it's all good.
He was turning on the video.
Oh.
Alright, so whenever you're ready.
Hi everyone, my name is Mitchell White. Thank you for coming to my senior project presentation. My senior project was to design, develop, and create an app called Latitude Advantage, which was intended to bring major league statistics and analytics to be usable at the high school level, essentially to make them free and accessible to everyone. My essential question was, how can I create a program that simulates high school baseball games and gives coaches data to improve their strategy? So the roadmap for the presentation. I'll start by talking about my inspiration, how I chose the project, talk about my important background info, my original project plan, look into the research I did, talk about the Python aspect, which is a really important part of the project, then go over the design of the simulator and show some of the code I wrote, and finally wrap it up by talking about my successes and failures. So, what was my inspiration for this project? It began back at the end of junior year when I learned Python in Mr. D's class. I had an interest in this idea of creating a baseball simulator using the Python I learned. Over the 2020 season, I saw the success of these Tampa Bay Rays, who used ideas really similar to my project, ideas of using analytics to win. It was also a way of helping the Mills baseball team. I'm not a very good baseball player, so I couldn't help them on the field, but I wanted to give them some kind of tools that might increase their chances of winning. So, quick background, what are analytics? For about 150 years, since three-piece suits were worn in dugouts to about 2000, baseball was managed pretty much exactly the same way. But that changed with this guy on the right, Billy Beane. Billy Beane was the first to play Moneyball, which is a game within a game. Moneyball is about using your resources to succeed in an absence of star talent. It's about putting your players in a position to succeed where they match up well. And this is the basis of my project. It's to let coaches know what the best uses of the strengths of their players are. So, the original gameplay. At the beginning, I wanted to research baseball and better understand how it was managed, how decisions were made. Next, I wanted to learn about the math of analytics. After that, I wanted to construct a blueprint using my research of how to simulate a baseball game. Then, create and develop a mock-up of the graphical user interface of the app. Then, learn more about Python, fill gaps I had in computer science. After that, build a graphical user interface, program the simulator, and finally, develop and improve the app. So, I'm going to show some of the research I did. This is just in the form of notes I took as the process went on. Early, you can see that these notes are very disorganized. They're just numbers, they're just things I'm writing down ideas I'm having. As it goes, it becomes more organized. It turns into graphics. It turns into charts of what I'm actually intending to do. And you can follow the evolution. Things become way more organized as I'm actually writing down the ideas of what's going to turn into my senior project. So, I want to talk for a second about how Python was used. This is a really important part of the project. So, my program is really at its core built on the Python function. A function is like a machine. You take an input, you put it in, you get an output. The function was the foundation of the project. Then, I used the TK graphical user interface module for the visual element of the project, essentially giving an interface between the user and the inner workings of the program. After that was the Pandas module. Pandas is about data frames. Data frames at their core are just ways to store numbers. Data frames were the backbone of the project. I needed them to store input data from users as well as the results from the simulators. And finally, the random module. My project was to do what was called a Monte Carlo simulation, which is when something's simulated over and over again. So to make accurate results for these hundreds of thousands of simulations, I needed a randomizer. And that was really the inner workings. They're used, like I said, at every step of the simulator. So, design. The original ideas for the project had coaches putting in 10 or 12 different individual statistics for every player. And these 10 or 12 statistics are a lot. It's not really convenient. So one of the first things I did was I found a way to slim that down. A coach is intended to put in 6 statistics. The program breaks down those statistics and turns them into a usable format for the simulator. And these statistics are especially important with hitting outcomes, batter versus pitcher. Early ideas were to take statistics and average them together, but that unfortunately doesn't work. What I ended up using was a version of the WOD5 method, which the specifics don't matter. It's essentially a way to take a batter, a pitcher, and figure out what the outcome would be. The only problem with that is that when you use that method, you can only get a yes or a no answer. That led to the outcome tree, which is shown on the left there. The outcome tree essentially had two options at every stage, and would go until a final decision was arrived at. And then for defense, this was one of the parts of the project I'm least proud of, because there are very few statistics about this. It was very difficult to make rigorous. Things like hit location, awareness of fielders, and errors, there's not really a concrete way to measure them and to measure their effect on the game, so it got a little bit wishy-washy at points. So now I'm going to show some of the code I did and some of the results of the code, starting out with the graphical user interface. So here it's going to show some of the code and me starting the project. And this is the title screen. And as you see, I click things, it opens up different windows. I can choose a left-handed and a right-handed pitcher. I can put in inputs for different aspects of the opposing team. And then I can hit to run the simulator. Unfortunately, I was not skilled enough with programming to get this working. Now I'm going to show you a point where I'm opening up a file searcher, which would be used to find the data frames I mentioned earlier and use them for the simulator. Next is some of the batter pitcher outcome code. So you can see the code here. When I run the simulator, it's going to show different outcomes. So now it says ground, or I think that was a strikeout actually. And now it's going to say flyout. That's an example of what the code does. It runs all of these random numbers using the quad5 method and gives you a result. So, and then I didn't think it was the best way of just showing the code working to show what I did in the pitcher decision base run code. I think it's better to show just the code that I wrote. So on the left here, you see the code for pitcher decision. It's kind of a wall. It's not really that intuitive. And then on the right here, I just scroll down through the code I wrote for base running just to show that it's a pretty difficult and painstaking process to just even code a somewhat simple thing. Next is the successes and failures. So for successes, I felt really good about the research and the design of the simulator that I did. I felt that I learned a lot about Python and I gained a lot of experience with programming, and I really saw how difficult programming can be. And I know this wasn't really a huge part of the senior project, but I used the engineering design process in a lot of different places in the code to go back to improve it. And as someone who wants to go into engineering, I felt like that was a really valuable experience. My failures, the coding I tried to do was too difficult and time consuming for my skill level. For a lot of the reasons I mentioned earlier, creating a rigorous simulation was pretty much impossible. In a lot of places, numbers I needed just didn't exist. It was too hard to simulate something accurately. I struggled a lot due to illness. I don't really need to explain that. And I ended up choosing the wrong project, in my opinion. I didn't play to my strengths. I instead made it way harder for myself than you. So my acknowledgments, Mr. D, for helping me learn Python from the beginning. Ms. Gopis, for helping me develop my idea. Mr. Carter, for helping me with the mock-up of the graphical user interface. My dad, for giving me the original idea. Colin Streck, for giving me a lot of ideas and helping me develop it. And Ms. Sheeny, for words of encouragement and good advice. My work's item. Questions?